Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus. I'm Teacher Morris and welcome to Next Gen Crossover. Crossover has been created to meet the specific needs of our students ages 10 to 12. I'm glad that you can join me and today as we start a brand new series called Hide and Seek. Our lessons will focus on temptation and sin. To open, we will have a crossover challenge. I call it Seek, Squat, and Swap. For this challenge, you need another person to do this with you. You can have any of your family member, your mom, dad, sister, brother, and others at home. Okay, these are the instructions. You are given 30 seconds to play. Seek. Looking in your puzzle, try to find the words that you are associated with the Bible. I will give the list later. Squat. While you are searching for a word, the other person with you will try to do some squats. Swap. After you find a word, swap with the other person. That other person will now seek a word and you will do squats. Just keep doing squat and swap until the countdown ends. Are you ready? Timer starts now. Now, time's up. How many words did you get? How many squats were you able to do? Here are the words that we were looking for. Matthew, Mark, Sin, John, Gospel, Cross, Jesus, God, Luke, and Temptation. I hope you enjoyed our challenge, but more importantly, we should always keep our bodies fit and minds sharp by reading God's Word. Let us pray before we continue. Father God, guide us as we study our lesson. Fill us with your Spirit. Give us wisdom to understand everything that we need to learn. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us now begin with our new series called Hide and Seek. Have you ever done something bad or sinful in your life? Let me define sin in the original translation of the Bible. It means to miss the mark. The mark is the standard of perfection set by God and modeled by Jesus. The Apostle Paul says in Romans chapter 3 verse 23, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. So, this only means we cannot compare ourselves to others, but it has something to do with obeying or being holy or set apart according to God's standards. When you disobey God's commands or do things that is not pleasing to God, you are sinning. Now, maybe you have taken some money from mom's wallet. You hid your brother or sister's stuff to get back at him. You have broken your dad's favorite mug. Or back in school, you have copied your seatmate's answer because he said it's okay. No one is looking. How did you feel about it? Have you asked yourself, is it okay if I didn't get caught? Let us read our Bible lesson today from 1 Timothy chapter 1 verses 18 to 19. This command I entrust to you, Timothy my son, in accordance with the prophecies previously made concerning you, that by them you fight the good fight, keeping faith and a good conscience, which some have rejected and suffered shipwreck in regard to their faith. To better understand what these Bible verses mean, we need to get a closer look. Now, this is a letter from the Apostle Paul that he wrote for Timothy. Timothy, at his age as a leader of the church, was very young. He was given a very hard task to stop false teachers from ruining the church in Ephesus. He was reminded of his God-given purpose and encouraged to remain faithful and to keep his integrity intact. Just like Timothy, God gave each of us a purpose, as followers of Jesus, our purpose is to be holy. That means we should avoid sin and we should obey the commands of God as written in the Bible. It is our God-given responsibility to share the gospel to others as well. If we fail to do these things and try to hide it, God will still see and know what is in our heart. And we all know that sin does not please God. I would like to go back to my question earlier. Have you ever done something bad or sinful in your life? How did you feel about it? When you took some money from your mom's wallet, did you get excited? When you hid your brother or sister's stuff to get back at them, were you happy? You have broken your dad's favorite mug, were you worried? When you have copied your seatmate's answer, did you feel afraid? You see, when you sin against God, it will only give you problems. Sooner or later, what you did will be discovered. There are consequences for it. You may get away from it now, but surely you cannot get away from God. We, as followers of Jesus, are not excused when we commit sin. That is why it is important for us to be Christ-like. How is it to be Christ-like? First, we need to know and understand Christ's character. He is holy. He is humble and obedient to God the Father. He is compassionate towards people. He taught people how to live according to God's will. He suffered and gave his life for people to be saved from sin and have eternal life. So how do we become Christ-like in character? Read the Word of God to remind you of your purpose. Keep yourself free from sin for you to be holy. Be humble towards others. If they hurt you, forgive them. Be obedient to your parents, even if sometimes you feel they do not understand you. Care to know the needs of others and help them with what you can. Share the gospel to your family, friends, and community. As a follower of Jesus, you must be Christ-like. To be Christ-like is not easy. To begin with Jesus, never sinned, and for us, we already failed in that area. But the good news for us, when we become followers of Jesus, we have Him and the Holy Spirit to help us. It will take time, but you should do it now. If you are tempted to sin, pray to God and ask for wisdom. If you feel that your effort is getting you nowhere, read the promise of God from the Bible. If others will look down on you as you see yourself or set yourself apart, remember it is Jesus that they are putting down. Let us pray.
Dear Jesus, I admit that I am a sinner. Forgive me for my shortcomings.
Help me become more like you and less of me. Teach me your ways and what pleases God. Holy Spirit, when I am tempted, help me to turn away. Give me the strength to say no to sin. All these things I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. This is our memory verse from Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2. For our series, Hide and Seek. And there's no creature hidden from his sight, but all things are open and laid bare to the eyes of him with whom we have to do. God sees everything. Nothing can hide from him. Here are some questions that you can talk about with your family and friends via phone call or through online. What makes it difficult for you to do the right thing? What words of encouragement do you remember from the Bible? What will you do to be Christ-like? Thank you for watching. If you have been blessed by our video today, send us your comments, like and share our posts, check out our other videos and downloadable content like Journal for Kids and Parent Guide from our Facebook page.